The next few months are going to be very busy for Apple. 2022 is almost here, and along with the new year comes lots of new products that might just change everything. So what secret projects is Apple looking to finish up and hopefully launch products from them soon? And also, why could 2022 be Apple's biggest year ever? Let me break down everything you need to know about Apple's plans for next year, some possible events maybe coming soon, and tell you the 8 most exciting things that Apple's looking to launch in the next few months and as we head into 2022. Sit back, relax, and get excited because there is something here for everyone to look forward to. And a big thanks to SetApp for sponsoring this video. Although there were some rumors about a possible last-minute November event, it doesn't look like that's going to happen. It seems like Apple has released all of their major products for this year. They're gonna sit back, work on some things for 2022, and hey, Apple did release a lot of cool, exciting products that are available right now. New AirPods, MacBook Pros, we got the new iMac, we have, of course, new iPhones. The Apple Watch might be a little hard to get your hands on these products, so order now if you want them in time for the holidays. But look, there's something here for everybody. Everything is pretty good, and 2021 was a good year for Apple, but 2022 is looking like it's gonna be even better. One of the first big announcements of 2022 might very well be another spring event, maybe something like Spring Loaded, where we get a bunch of new products releasing in the March-April timeframe, or hopefully, I mean the earlier the better, to get our next Apple event. And what we should see at that event will be a couple of big things. The first will most likely be the next generation of Apple Silicon. So we have the M1, the M1 Pro, the M1 Max, and the next piece of Apple Silicon launching should be the M2, which leads us to the obvious question of what could be the first Mac that comes equipped with the M2 Apple Silicon, and that, by all accounts, looks to be an all-new, redesigned MacBook Air. According to the rumors and renders, the design is going to be significantly different and looks really good. It's Apple, again, sort of continuing to embrace this industrial design language and also bringing a very nice color palette, similar, if not the exact same options as what we have on the iMac right now. So if you want a splash of color on your MacBook Air, that should be coming very soon. And to the dismay or the excitement of many, the notch will be there. It looks like Apple is going to take what they've done with the notch on the MacBook Pro and sort of make that a thing, at least on their Apple portable laptops, and the notch will be there on the MacBook Air. Again, do not expect Face ID to be here, no special sensors really. It's really going to house the webcam, which should be an upgraded, hopefully 1080p webcam. Nothing crazy here, but yes, the notch will most likely be here on the new MacBook Air. Another big upgrade to the MacBook Air will also probably be with the display. We have heard some rumors that Apple is going to actually put a mini LED display into the MacBook Air. So it's gonna be really vibrant, really bright, really colorful. It's gonna be great for watching videos and movies and consuming content and creating content, all that stuff. But a clear distinction here is that it probably will not be a ProMotion display. Another change coming from the MacBook Pro is the return of MagSafe. Yes, just like the notch, it seems like Apple is making this change across the board, and MagSafe is expected to come to these new MacBook Airs. Now again, little distinction here, the port selection on the MacBook Pro seems to be exclusive to those models. So no full-size HDMI port, no SD card slot, it's gonna be just USB-C and a headphone jack. Now along with those rumors of a new MacBook Air, there have also been some rumors about a new redesigned Mac Mini, and these rumors have sort of been all over the place and don't exactly make a whole lot of sense. On one hand, it would be great to see Apple redesign the Mac Mini, give us a bunch of ports on the back like USB-A ports, USB-C ports, full-size HDMI ports, basically a great selection of ports with that MagSafe power port on there as well, and also give us a selection of colors. And as much as I love to see the colors and the ports and the redesign, all that stuff is great, the one big question I have is what will the actual chip powering this all actually be? Will it be the M1 Pro or the M1 Max? Will it be the M2? Because this is going to have colors, that kind of makes you believe that it's more of a consumer-focused model that Apple is going to put an M2 in and call it a day. But we also had heard some really strong rumors that Apple is going to make a Mac Mini more pro-focused with these additional ports and should have the same chip that powers the new MacBook Pro, which is not the M1X, but the M1 Pro or M1 Max, inside of the Mac Mini as well. So I could see Apple sort of offering a different configuration selection for the pro users and the consumers. So you can option this maybe with an M2 or all the way up to an M1 Pro or M1 Max, but there are some rumors that it could happen. In fact, we sort of broke down all the rumors on the new Mac Mini and all the new Macs on the latest episode of the Apple Circle podcast, where myself and Matt Gonzalez go through all the hot Apple news of the week. We break down all the rumors, we talk about leaks, we talk about everything you need to know in the wild world of Apple. If you guys want to check that out and subscribe, which I recommend you do, it's a great podcast. If I do say so myself, check out the link to the Apple Circle podcast linked right down below. Now, another Mac we know with a lot of confidence is for sure coming next year, hopefully probably the end, I guess, of 2022, Apple's gonna take their sweet time, is the next generation Mac Pro. This is the Apple Silicon powered Mac Pro. It's supposed to be smaller, but still offer a lot of power, flexibility, maybe even some modularity as well. And we don't know a whole lot of specifics in terms of design or power or pricing, but have no doubt this should be the most powerful, most capable, the most versatile Mac you can buy. And this seems like it's going to be an absolute beast. Before we continue with more on the next generation of Macs and Apple Silicon and other Apple products, let me take a quick break and tell you a bit about this video's sponsor, ZetApp. Now, whether you've got a new Mac or an older Mac, I think we can all agree that one of the best parts of macOS is, of course, the apps. But it oftentimes can be really difficult to sort through this never-ending sea of apps and try to find the good ones from the bad ones, separate the ones that are worth your time from the ones that aren't. And also, some of the good apps that you'd want to buy are really expensive if you purchase them individually. But that's where the magic of ZetApp comes in. It's a curated collection of over 220 of the best Mac apps, all available for just $9.99 a month. With ZetApp, you're getting access to some of the best Mac apps of all time, including some of my personal favorites like Ulysses, which is an excellent writing app, and Disk Drill, a great data recovery app that has saved my digital life on more than one occasion, plus many, many more amazing apps. And whether you're looking for a great collection of apps for getting things done or just relaxing and playing some games, ZetApp has got you covered with a wide variety of excellent apps, again, all available for just one low monthly price. I am just a huge fan of ZetApp. I love having access to this incredible catalog of Mac apps through ZetApp. Also, I feel like I can get more done with these apps, and my Mac experience as a whole is sort of supercharged because of the apps I have access to through ZetApp. I love ZetApp, I'm a big fan. If you guys wanna check it out for yourself and learn more today and try ZetApp for free for 7 days, hit the link right down below to learn more. And last but certainly not least, the other wild card Mac that should be launching sometime in 2022 is the rumored iMac Pro. Now, there has been a lot of talk about this, a lot of speculation. We thought we were gonna get it last year with the Spring Loaded event, but that did not happen. So we really don't know a lot about what this machine is gonna look like or what it's gonna have inside, but we know Apple is working on it and testing it, and it should be coming hopefully sometime next year. There has been some new information released from display analyst Ross Young that says that this new iMac Pro, codenamed rumored iMac Pro, will come equipped with a 27-inch mini LED display that is capable of ProMotion. So think of this almost sort of like a mini Pro Display XDR, but almost better. A better mini LED panel, ProMotion support, obviously larger than the current iMac. This should be a really beautiful and also really powerful computer that should just be the iMac Pro that everyone has been waiting for. Hopefully we see this come equipped with a couple of different options, hopefully an M1 Pro or an M1 Max. This should be sort of a higher end iMac, so you should have better thermals, you should have higher end chips, more options to expand with graphics cores and high performance cores. All of that should be there with the iMac Pro. Again, very little is known besides a really great screen on this computer. So we expect to see this sometime next year in 2022. We know Apple's testing it, so hopefully we see it sooner than later. Of course, coming next fall in 2022 will be the debut of the iPhone 14 lineup. That should be a really substantial update, new screen sizes, new design, better camera system, maybe better displays, a hole punch instead of a notch. Lots of exciting stuff to look forward to with the iPhone 14. I will not rehash it all here. If you wanna know everything about the iPhone 14 from top to bottom, inside out, check out the video linked to up here and down below. But let me just say, the iPhone 14 is going to be a big deal, a really big upgrade, and possibly be the perfect iPhone or the one that many people have long been waiting for. iPhone 14 is still a little bit of ways away, but it's going to be a really big upgrade and should be a really awesome iPhone. In addition to iPhone 14, another iPhone launching next year, possibly sooner than the iPhone 14, maybe sometime in the spring, will be iPhone SE 3. Now, there have been some wild rumors about this for the last 12 months about what the design could be. It could look like the iPhone 11, it's gonna get two cameras, it's gonna have 5G, it could have a higher end, maybe an OLED display. a Face ID, what's Apple gonna do with the iPhone SE 3? Well, as of right now, it looks like the iPhone SE 3 is going to remain very similar in terms of price and design and features to the current iPhone SE, which is basically the body of the iPhone 8. So it'll still have a single camera, still have the same screen size, same LCD display, probably still Touch ID home button, but the internals should get a boost. You probably will have a newer Apple processor, if not the A15 Bionic from the iPhone 13 line, which will be really great, super powerful, super efficient. Also, this should have 5G. So this will be Apple's lowest cost 5G iPhone that you can buy, which will be nice to see at the lower end. And obviously some spec improvements, probably a better camera system in there as well. Still single camera, but probably a better camera, and still a really great buy for just a few $100s. That will probably come maybe in the spring, probably sooner again than later, probably not till the fall for the iPhone 14, but iPhone SE 3, if you're waiting for that, a nice low cost option with 5G is probably coming in the spring of 2022, though don't expect any radical design changes. Not gonna happen with the iPhone SE. And last but certainly not least, AirPods Pro will also be getting an update in 2022. Surprisingly, it's been almost, or I guess just over 2 years since the original AirPods Pro debuted in October of 2019. Hard to believe that AirPods Pro have been out for 2 years, they're still really great, and AirPods Pro 2 should be even better. Again, information on this is sparse. We had heard that Apple is working to add some new health sensors and some new metrics that could be collected by the AirPods Pro sitting in your ears, so great for workouts and health nuts and stuff like that. And also, we've seen some leaked alleged photos of an AirPods Pro case that comes equipped with a built-in speaker for Find My support, so you'd actually ping it through the Find My app and actually hear an audible sound, and also a little attachment there for attaching it to your keys or a lanyard, basically a way to permanently attach your AirPods Pro built into the actual physical case on AirPods Pro 2, at least according to the rumors. Of course, we know Apple is also hard at work on many other secret projects. There's the Apple Mixed Reality headset that we should see in 2022, fingers crossed, the Apple AR glasses, the Apple Car. Apple is working on a lot of different things that we know about and a lot I'm sure we don't know about, but 2022 should be a really big year with the iPhone 14 and the continued transition to Apple Silicon and the redesigned MacBook Air and new Macs. This is gonna be a really great year, whether you want new AirPods, you want an iPad, you want a Mac, an iPhone, there is something for everyone to look forward to coming very soon in just a few months, surprisingly, in 2022. So that's all you need to know right now. Looks like a very exciting couple of months ahead. And what are your thoughts? What are you most looking forward to from Apple next year? Are you waiting for the next generation Apple Silicon Mac? Are you holding out a hope and really wanting to buy an iMac Pro? Or are you saving your money and saving your pennies for the iPhone 14 and that no notch? Or are you waiting for something else? Let me know your thoughts on Apple's plans for next year down below. Let me know what you're most looking forward to and what you're planning to buy. And I think that's gonna do it for me, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I'm Robert Rosenfeld from the Apple Circle, and I will see you all in the next one.